Good morning, students. So today we will learn about principles of growth and development. The first principle is the growth and development of cephalocaudal. Means this principle describes the direction of growth and development. The head region start growth at first and following by which other organs starts developing. The child gains control of the head first, then the arms and then the legs. Infants develop control of the head and face movements at first 2 months. In next few months, they are able to lift themselves up by using their arms, and next gain control over leg and able to crawl, stand, walk, run, jump, climb day by day. The second one is the proximo-distal direction. The process in proximo-distal from center or midline to periphery directions, as you can see in the image. Development proceeds from near to far outward from central axis of the body towards the extremities. Proximo-distal means center or midline. Growth proceeds from the center or midline of the body to the periphery or in a proximo-distal direction. During the prenatal period, the limb buds develop before the rudimentary fingers and toes. During infancy, the large muscles of the arms and legs are subject to voluntary control. Earlier then are the fine muscles of the hands and feet. The spinal cord develops before outer parts of the body. The third one is the growth and development is a continuous process. Growth and development is a continuous process from conception to death. In the early years of life, development consists of changes that lead the child to maturity, not only of body size and functioning but also of behavior. Even after maturity has been attained, development does not end. These changes continue until death and the life cycle. The fourth one is the growth and development is orderly or sequential process. Every species, whether animal or human, follows a pattern of development. This pattern in general is the same for all individuals. All children follow a development pattern with one stage leading to the next. For example, infants stand before they walk and draw circles before they make squares. And the fifth one is influenced by environmental and genetic factor. And the sixth one is the growth and development is noticeable. Development proceeds from simple to complex. Children use their cognitive and language skills to reason and solve the problems. Children at first are able hold the big things by using both arms. In the next part, able to hold things in a single hand, then only able to pick small objects like peas, cereals, etc. A children, when able to hold pencil, first start draw circles, then squares, then only letters, after that the words. And the eighth principle is the individual difference. The tempo of development is not even. Individuals differ in the rate of growth and development. Boys and girls have different development rates. Each part of the body has its own particular rate of growth. Development does not occur at the even pace. There are periods of great intensity and equilibrium, and there are periods of imbalance. Development achieves a plateau, and this may occur at any level or between levels. The ninth one is the rate of growth and development is interrelated. And the tenth one is skills are learned by notice. Proceeds from general to specific. Development proceeds from general to specific. In all areas of development, general activities always precedes specific activity. For example, the fetus moves its whole body but incapable of making specific responses. Infants wear their arms randomly. Infants wave their arms randomly. They can make such specific responses as reaching out for an object near them. Thank you.